Dear viewers, Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today we are going to talk about inner peace. In today's world, there are many people who are suffering from stress, anxiety, they're suffering from depression. So the root cause for all the sufferings of anxiety, depression, stress, if you look at the root cause of it all, the root cause is desires. Quran says in Surah Furqan, Surah number 25, Ayat number 43, Allah says, أَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَٰهَهُ هَوَاهُ. Have you not seen the one who has taken for a god his own desires? So the Quran says, a person who has taken for a god his own desires. Desires are the cause of our misery. If you see the misery of a people, there will be at its root, the cause will be desire. For example, a person is having a motorcycle. Now he is not satisfied with that motorcycle. He wants something else. He wants a car. So during that period till he gets a car, he is in anxiety. He is suffering from anxiety. He is not at peace. Similarly, a person having a car, for example, a Maruti 800, then he has a desire to get a Mercedes. So during that period till he gets a Mercedes car, he is not at peace. He'll be suffering from anxiety. He'll be stressed out. Until and unless we stop hankering, we can never be at peace. So hankering must stop. These false desires must stop. That we get a thing, then we want something else. This process will never end. A person who has a flat, he wants a bungalow. So same, if he has a bungalow, he wants another. So your desires, they never end. This is a whole process. It keeps on coming. If you get one thing, your heart will desire another. So it will never stop. So what is the ilaj? What is the treatment for the disease? This disease, what is the treatment for the disease of desires? The treatment is the desire of God, desire of Allah in itself. Quran says in Surah Ra'd, Surah number 13, Ayat number 28, Allah says, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, that those who believe and those whose hearts find satisfaction in the remembrance of Allah, أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ, verily in the remembrance of Allah, hearts do find satisfaction. أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. So itminani qalb, that satisfaction of the heart, it comes from when you have an ultimate object of desire. Then all other vain desires, they'll perish by itself. If you have an ultimate desire, that is of God in itself. So Allah bi dhikrillahi tatma'innul qulub, for verily hearts find satisfaction in the remembrance of God. Another means by which you can end the desires, there are many things, but the ultimate is the desire of God, desire of Allah, that your ultimate desire is of God in itself. So this will take away all your other vain desires. They are false desires of this world, of this dunya. So we have to always count upon his blessings to rid of our miseries, of our desires. We have to have content with what he has given. Quran says in Surah Ibrahim, Surah number 14, Ayat number 34, Allah says, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you were to number the blessings of Allah, never you will be able to count them. There are so many blessings he has given. Health in itself is a great blessing. If you look at your health only, that if he gives you a suffering, if you gives an illness, then you remember when you were healthy. You start remembering all these things that when you were healthy, and then you have lost whatever you are having right now. If it is taken away, then you will realize what you already had. So you should be satisfied with the decree of Allah, what He has given you, what you already possess. إن تعدوا نعمة الله لا تحصوها. You will never be able to count them. He has given you the power to see. He has given you the power to hear. He has given you the power to taste something, to enjoy something. These are all His blessings. So you should always be thankful to Him for this. Quran says in Surah Ibrahim, Surah number 14, Ayat number 7, Allah says, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. And your Lord has declared that if you are grateful, لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ, He will give you more. So if you are grateful, He will give you more. So we should rid of our desires and should be contented with what He has given. The problem with people is that they always look above themselves. What they don't have, they look at those things and what others are possessing which they don't have. So that is the, again, this is actually our desires playing on. So this creates misery again, suffering, anxiety and all those things. So we should always look down upon people who are not having what God has given us. This will rid our miseries and will give satisfaction to the heart. Another cause which is the cause of our misery, depression, anxiety and all these things are problems in actual and sufferings, the musibah. If like someone meets an accident, there is some loss of life, loss of property, loss of health, all these things, they also create depression, anxiety and all these things. So how you have to deal with all these things? So how you will deal with all these things, with the problems in actual, when you are having some suffering, some problem, some loss of life, some loss of material things and all these things? The Quran says in Surah Hud, Surah number 11, Ayat number 9, Allah says, وَلَئِنْ أَذَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنَّا رَحْمَةً ثُمَّ نَزَعْنَاهَا مِنْ. When we give man a taste of our mercy and then we withdraw it, then he becomes ungrateful and is in despair. So when you are having the blessings, at that time you are at peace. Oh, you have good things and everything is going good. That time a person is at peace. But when some problem comes up, he loses all hopes and he becomes ungrateful. That should never happen. One must be try to be grateful as much as he can. وَإِسْتَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. That if you are grateful, he'll give you more. So one must always try to be grateful, whatever the situation comes. And how he should deal with the problems? It is with utter faith and trust in God, in Allah. And that he should trust upon God. Quran says in Surah Taghabun, Surah number 64, Ayat number 11, مَا أَصَابَ مِن مُصِيبَةٍ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. That you are not inflicted with the suffering, with the problem, with the musibah, except by leave of Allah. وَمَن يُؤْمِن بِاللَّهِ يَحْتِي قَلْبَهُ. But one who has utter faith in Allah, then he will guide his heart. He'll keep upright his heart. He'll guide his heart. It will not astray. That you must be grateful to God, and even in your sufferings, you must remember His blessings. You must be grateful. So with utter faith and utter trust in God, that you will be upright, your heart will be upright, and you must be grateful, and you deal with all the sufferings, all the problems with sabr, with patience. Allah says, وَاسْبِرْ عَلَى مَا أَصَابَكَ. Have patience at whatever comes upon you. So whatever hits you, whatever problem hits you, whatever suffering hits you, you should be always patient. You should deal with it with patience. And it is akin to shukr, which is gratefulness. So if you are having patience at your suffering, then indirectly you are thanking Him. So these are the means to deal with our sorrows, with our miseries, so that we can attain inner peace. So sabr, shukr, contentment, desiring God focusing your ultimate target, which is God. We are to return to Him. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We belong to Allah and to Him is our return. So in the end, we must know that this life is a test for hereafter. Allah says in Surah Mulk, Surah number 67, Ayat number 2, Ya alladhi khalaqal mawta wal hayata liyabluwakum ayyukum ahsanu amala. That He has created death and life to test which of you are good in deeds. He'll test you with sorrow. He'll test you with loss of life. He'll test you with hunger, with poverty, with everything. He'll also test you with giving wealth. He'll test you with success. He'll test you with everything. أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. That do men think that they'll be left alone saying we believe and they will not be tested? So you, everyone will be tested. So this life is a test for the next life, for the hereafter. So we must deal with our miseries by ourselves. We must have patience, we must be grateful, we must have utter faith and trust in God, and we must shift our desires. We should kill our vain desires and focus them upon the ultimate truth, upon the ultimate goal. Then only we can rid of our miseries. Otherwise, if you are hankering, going around wanting things from this life, you cannot have it all. وَمَا عَلَيْنَا إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ.